Hi, Jason with Tormach. Today we're machining titanium. We wanted to freshen up our logo plate a little bit and decided that we should definitely machine this out of titanium. So we partnered up with Harvey Tool on this project. So let's jump into the cutting, talk about speeds, feeds, work holding, and all the challenges that we faced along the way. So let's go make this. All right, so let's jump into the cutting here. As you can see, it's a 12 by 6 inch, 3/4 inch thick, commercially pure grade 2 titanium. We mounted it to a fixture plate using super glue and the blue painter's tape. I always kind of wanted to try it on a bigger, harder to machine piece of material, and it worked for us. We did run into a couple little problems that I'll point out here in a second. So as you can see, we're cutting. We have a 3/8 inch cutter. It's a 3/8 inch 4 flute with a corner radius on it. All the tooling and stuff that we use in this project are from Harvey Tool. I've been using their tooling for about 10 years, and it's just been, it's been great. It's always worked well. The company's been really good to work with, and when we had to get some small tooling and everything to make a part like this, I definitely called Harvey right away, and we worked out what tools and stuff would work well. They actually put me in touch with their applications engineer, and he helped me cook up some recipes and get good starting points for all their tooling. So as you can see here, this is on the back side of the plate, and right here you'll notice that the part actually moves and we get some extra chatter. So what happened was the cast surface finish on the plate allowed the coolant to seep in there, and then the tape failed, so the part actually came off the fixture a little bit. Luckily it didn't completely let go and it just vibrated for us, so we were able to remove the part, and then as you can see we just flipped it over, put it in the vises and machined it flat so that we were able to save the part and just go ahead and finish it. So we're working through this here. We're just cutting a series of pockets in the back just to kind of remove some weight and make it look nice. But on this 3/8, we got everything dialed in and running pretty well. Again, it was 350 surface footage, programmed it at a 2,000 8/10 chip load, which worked out to right around 40 inches a minute. Our depth of cut was 3/8 inch with a 40,000 step over. When we were ramping into these pockets, we were at a 2-degree ramp when we did the backside. This was a little bit aggressive just due to the chip clearing problems. We did really have to manage the coolant and the nozzle and the quantity of coolant coming out of it just to make sure that we didn't have chip buildup. Grade 2 titanium is very soft. It's about a 80 to a 90 hardness on the Brunel scale. In comparison, something like 6AL, which is a real common alloy people are used to, will be 350 on the Brunel scale. So it's a very soft, very gummy material. So it's a challenge to clear chips with it. So we kind of tweaked it up and stuff as we went, but it was one of the big challenges that we faced with this project was the material itself being really gummy. But as you can see, we were able to rough out the pockets. Everything cut real nice once we got our recipes dialed in. So once we got the parts, pockets roughed out, we came back with the same cutter and we finished the top surface and the bottom of the pockets. When finishing the pockets, I did leave material on the walls, so I have a separate finish pass that comes back and cleans the walls up. I do this to keep a consistent cutter load, and it helps improve surface finish. It's just something that we've kind of always done. Pretty much cut the entire backside of this part with the same tool. So we used a 3/8 on all of it, and then we came back with a real small little corner rounding tool. When we designed this, I started adding fillets and stuff just to kind of deburr the part, but I didn't want to change the aesthetic of the part, and we started putting a 30,000 corner break on everything. It really changed the appearance of the part. So Harvey Tool actually offers a 5,000 corner rounding tool that has a 46,000 diameter tip on it. So when we flip the part over and cut the logo side of this plate, we're able to get in to all the little detail with this tool. So it's pretty nice, pretty cool little tool to be able to use. Definitely the first time I've ever had to use this small of a corner rounding tool, but it was actually really easy to program and really easy to use. And it just broke the edge enough that you didn't feel the burr, but aesthetically it still left everything looking really nice. So you see we got op one, the first side all wrapped up. Then we flip this thing over and go ahead and rough out the logo. So we use a handful of different tools on this. I started with the 3/8 and worked my way down to a 50,000 diameter. The pocket on this side of the part is 225,000 deep. We just took everything at full depth of cut. So the 3/8 was cut in 225 deep, and so was that little 50,000. I was really impressed with that little 50,000 end mill. That's almost 5 times diameter on depth of cut. So once we get up to that footage here, I was really impressed with that and really happy how that tool ran. But we ran this 3/8 tool at the same speeds and feeds. We did change the ramp angle on everything to 1.5 degrees just to help with chip management and keep the tools from loading up when we were ramping into the part. Once we were done with 3/8, we came back with a little 3/16 cutter. And we ran this at the same surface footage and everything, so we're at 350 surface footage. We programmed this at a 1,310 strip load per tooth, and this was also a four flute cutter. And as you can see, I lit one up. We had that chip management issue that I mentioned where we were helicaling into the hole and we weren't able to clear the chips effectively. So as you can see, that cutter got nice and hot and turned red. Titanium is one of those materials that likes coolant and then more coolant. I actually extended the tool out of the holder a little more to get better access for the coolant and the flushing to just fix that problem. And once we had those little issues resolved, we were able to cut the rest of the part and everything without any problems. So once we're wrapped up with the 3/16 cutter, we came back with an 1/8 inch just to clean out the corners and put a little bit more detail in. We ran the same surface footage as we did before, which is 350 surface footage. We ran this at a 1,310 chip load. This is also a four flute cutter. And our depth of cut, 225 thousandths, so step over is about 37 thousandths of an inch. And everything just ran real nice. Honestly, we have another one of these plates to make, and I'm probably gonna turn up some speeds and feeds on that just to see how it runs and see what we can actually get out of these tools. So stay tuned for that video. We'll definitely cut this again and lean on these tools a little bit more to see what we can get out of them. But overall, I mean, I was very happy with it. We ran into real minimal problems. The recommendations we got from Harvey Tool were excellent, and everything just worked. Then once we wrapped up with that 92,000 end mill, we got to go down to that little guy, the 50,000. This tool has honestly just kept making me smile and laugh the whole time I was using it. I've never ran a cutter that small at that kind of depth of cut before, so it was definitely a fun experience to be able to work through. It was much easier than I expected. The recommendations, again, that I got from Harvey Tool were excellent, and we put it in at their numbers, and they just worked. So on that cutter, we actually ran it. We went full depth, so we went 225 thou deep at a 2% step over, which ended up being a 1/1000th of an inch step over. As you can see in the footage here, it made chips, it cut really nice. One of the big things when you're cutting titanium is you can't be scared of it. You have to take a chip. The material is a little, it's resistant to being machined when you're cutting it, so you have to get in and you have to take a bite, otherwise you'll end up work hardening and wearing out your tools. So as you can see, this little 50,000 end mill had a decent amount of work to do, and it very efficiently removed all that material. I was very happy with it. We did have to do some full slotting with it to get the detail through the center of the T logo. So when we did the slotting and everything, we had to change our depths of cut. So we came in and we did the slotting here. We did a 30% of tool diameter for our step down. And then we ran it at about a 1/10 1/2 per tooth chip load on that. As you can see in the footage here, it just cut. Put the numbers in and it just ran. Everything ran nice. It was forming good chips. We were able to keep the chips in the, you know, in a good state, so we didn't run into any recutting issues or anything like that. I was pretty excited about this. It was fun. Taking a cutter at 5x diameter is I find very fun. So it was definitely a fun project and a fun part of it for us. And once we finished it all up, we used a 90,000 end mill to finish the floors. I wanted to get the tool pass to lay out and kind of just follow the Tormach logo and the name and stuff around to kind of give it that offset pattern. And then we came back with a 50,000 end mill and we just did all the wall finishing with that just to get a nice, clean, consistent surface finish on the whole thing. And then once we wrapped up with this guy, we came back with that little 5/1000 corner rounding tool again just to break all the edges and just to deburr the part. So there it is, all wrapped up, all clean. Really happy with the way it turned out. Excited to have been able to work on this project and to do it. It was fun. So thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Check out more of our YouTube videos here. And for more metal tips, tricks, and stories, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.